بینندگان عزیز، با سلام به شما. همون جوری که دیروز گفتم در برنامه، امروز پنجشنبه دوم فوریه سال 2017 میلادی با یکی از دوستان آمریکایی که سالهاست میشناسم ایشون رو و قبلا هم باشون مصاحبه داشتم موقعی که توی FPA بودم و ایشون دیرکتور آف فیوچر آف ایران اینستیتیو هستن که در اتلانتیک کانسل سالهای سال هست کار میکنن. چندین سفر به ایران رفتن و دلیلی که از ایشون دعوت کردم اینه که الان شرایط ایران و آمریکا خیلی حساس شده. همینجا از شما میخوام اجازه بدین من با ایشون انگلیسی صحبت کنم و بتونیم با هم چند تا سوال رو مطرح کنیم. Barbara, thank you very much for accepting my invitation and welcome to Mardom TV again. I was telling you know, my viewer that I know you about 18 to 20 years and I really appreciate that you do try to show American people that we are not what they try to say, we are not terrorists. Today I was reading that so far Iran gave America 6,000 grad, not a student, you know, grad, and about 7,000 or to 6,500 doctors. And this is a shame that they put us in that list when, you know, whoever was those country, that four country was in charge for that, catastrophe back 2001. None of their name is over there. I just stop over here and let you explain for us what is going on, and especially for that meeting that you had last Monday, please elaborate for me and our viewer what is going on, what we should do, how we can get more involved, and really it's confusing time. Okay, thanks again for being with us, and you go ahead, and mic is yours now.
Thank you very much. Thank you for inviting me to speak again. It's a great pleasure. The last few days have been very, very upsetting for those of us who care about a better relationship between the United States and Iran. This visa ban, I think, is a disaster from every aspect. It is hurting ordinary people. It is hurting the interests of the United States. As you pointed out, the United States has benefited from Iranians coming here, particularly Iranian students. There are about 12,500 who are mostly graduate students, and they are studying mostly in the STEM field, science and mathematics and so on. Many of them wind up contributing to research or getting involved in startups, and they are just a terrific asset to the United States. Of course, I also support people-to-people ties between the United States and Iran, all kinds of exchanges, and now those are going to be very, very difficult to put together because of this travel ban. It's our hope that this is just a temporary measure. The Trump administration has called it a pause, and I hope that they will review and reflect. People who come here from the countries affected already go through very extreme vetting. It's a long and difficult procedure. We brought an Iranian filmmaker last year to come and show a documentary on the Hamoun wetlands at the Atlantic Council, and it took us months to arrange his visa because of this kind of vetting that goes on. So there is really no need to add any more procedures to this, and I hope that the administration will realize, once it reviews the situation, that the vetting is already very, very extreme, and that they will allow these people to continue to come to the United States. You know, there is a certain xenophobia and a certain Islamophobia that characterizes this administration, which is completely unfounded. Muslims represent a very small percentage of the American population, and many of them are converts to Islam who are native-born Americans. So this kind of ban on people coming from Muslim countries is really quite pointless. It will alienate people. Certainly, I hope it does not alienate Iranians. I hope they understand that many Americans are opposed to these kinds of measures, And of course, you saw massive demonstrations in the United States last weekend against the ban, with people saying that refugees and foreign visitors are welcome in this country. And that is certainly the case, I think, in many parts of the United States. I'm hoping to organize an event with university presidents to talk about the contribution that Iranians are making to American universities. So I would say, please do not give up hope. We will not give up hope. We will continue to fight against these measures and to try to convince the administration that they are counterproductive, that they will not help the United States fight terrorism. In fact, the reverse. You mentioned the event that we had on Monday. We had a half-day event on the Iran nuclear agreement. Of course, many of us were supporters of this agreement. We think it's very important to resolve problems between the United States and the Iranian government through diplomacy. And, of course, the nuclear deal is the best example of this. It puts restrictions on the Iranian nuclear program in return for sanctions relief. And it was very welcome, and we are hopeful that the Trump administration will not do anything to jeopardize this agreement. In the same way, we hope that Iran will not do anything to jeopardize this agreement. There is now a war of words over Iran's missile tests. The missile tests are separate from the nuclear agreement. They are inconsistent with a separate UN resolution, but they do not violate that resolution. And we hope that this topic will be something for diplomatic conversations. If the United States would like Iran to put limits on its missile program, then the United States is going to have to offer some incentives, I think, not simply threats. And so far, of course, all we have heard is threats about this, that Iran is on notice, whatever that means. So this is a very tense time. It's a very difficult time. I don't recall, frankly, such a tense and difficult time in all the years that I've been working on this issue. But I hope that we will get through it, that this is just the beginning of an administration that needs to find its way. It's trying to put down some markers. It's trying to sound tough. But I hope that there will be an understanding that that certainly there are other ways to influence Iran besides threats. In my experience, threats are counterproductive with Iran. It's much better to offer a reasoned exchange of views in a diplomatic form than simply to make threats. But, you know, we are where we are, okay. Unfortunately.
Thank you for trying to organize more speakers, you know, from university and so on. But for people like me, just regular citizens, Persian people that they are here, either they are citizen, American citizen like me, or they are just holding green card. What do you recommend? What we should do? For example, yesterday I called the Congress lady from here and two senators. Do they work when you call and
yes.
Talk? And what more we can do?
I think calling senators and congressmen is very, very important. I think that is one of the best ways to influence the system. The other thing is to give money to support the American Civil Liberties Union and other organizations that are challenging the visa ban in the American court system. They succeeded in getting a stay, as they put it, on deporting people who arrived or who were en route to the United States when this decision was made. And they are challenging this visa ban as unconstitutional and illegal. There is a 1965 law that forbids putting these kinds of restrictions on refugees and other immigrants according to their origin, according to the nation that they come from. The Constitution forbids discrimination on religious grounds. So I think the court challenges will be very, very important, in addition to the political pressure that we can put through calling your congressmen, calling your senators, and also demonstrating. There were spontaneous demonstrations at airports and in Washington, D.C., and in Boston and New York, many places. And it's important to continue these demonstrations so that it will have an influence on the administration, and it will also show the world that many Americans oppose these kinds of measures, and that we believe that the United States is great because it is a country of immigrants, because it is open to people from all cultures, from all faiths, who want to come here and learn and make a contribution, whether they stay here or they go back to their home countries. This is the kind of place that we want to be. I'm the grandchild of immigrants. Almost every American, except for Native Americans, let's face it, we are all the grandchildren, the children, the great-grandchildren of immigrants. And this is what has renewed our culture and our society, and made us a country that at least has been seen in the past as a beacon of freedom. We don't want to destroy that.
Thank you so much. You said there are some organizations that we can support them, that they go and legally follow this or push it. Can you name some of them?
Yes, I mentioned the American Civil Liberties Union, the ACLU.
ACLU.
They brought the suit that stopped the implementation of this ban on people who had already arrived in the United States. And they are continuing, and there are other groups as well, but this one is one of the main ones. And you can also support NIAC, you can support the Atlantic Council, you can support all the organizations that are trying to present an accurate picture of Iranians in the United States, and that are fighting back against these very harmful stereotypes.
To be honest with you, I didn't know that Atlantic Council is more than half a century old, and you said people can support it.
Yes, they can join the Atlantic Council.
My
program is about 6 years old now.
Yes.
And, you know, if people join the Atlantic Council and they say they're joining it because of the Iran program, that's very helpful to me. That means I will keep my job for a little bit longer. So, you know, this is all welcome. There are very few places in Washington, D.C. where you can see programs like the one that we put on Monday. And we are going to continue to do these kinds of events to the extent possible.
Let's go back to Monday program. At the end, there was a resolution or something, or plan what to do. Can you elaborate that for us or inform us about that?
Yeah, I think there was a consensus that came out from the discussions that we should keep the Iran nuclear deal. And if the administration would like to extend it or add some other aspects to it, that it should ask Iran to start new negotiations on a kind of JCPOA, or I think you call it Barjom, right?
Barjom, yeah.
2.0. You know, we can start new negotiations to take effect after this particular agreement is no longer in effect. And I think that would be a fine proposal to make. But in the meantime, we should enforce the agreement on both sides and not do anything that would take away from it. That means that if Congress tries to pass legislation that would reimpose the same sanctions on Iran that were taken away under the nuclear agreement, that the administration should not support this. We should not support this.
Thank you very much.
It's very important to preserve the benefits of this agreement.
You said you mean version 2 of Barjom. I heard Mr.
Zarif.
Mr. Zarif is trying to do so. Is that true or what?
I don't think quite yet. Look, I think we need a track record of enforcement by both sides for a little while. But at some point, once the Trump administration has all of its people in place, you know, they still haven't filled a lot of very important positions in the State Department and in the Defense Department and so on. But once, you know, it is fully staffed, perhaps, you know, by the end of this year, that would be an appropriate time to seek discussions. And we should seek them. You know, the Trump administration says it doesn't like multilateral agreements. It doesn't like multilateral negotiations. Fine, why not talk directly to Iran? We have channels that were already established under the JCPOA there, and they can be used. We have a new Secretary of State. I'm sure if he would like to meet Mr. Zarif, that could be arranged. You know, but this is going to take some preparation. So I think this is something that could come you know, some months from now, not immediately.
Okay. Last question I have for you is Iran on notice. Even they don't know. You smile. Okay.
We don't know what this means. What does this mean? You know, there was a briefing from the White House yesterday, and people were asked, you know, and they said, well, all these options. Well, what options? They did not specify. You know, I think this was just a way of looking tough and looking tougher than the Obama administration, which was considered too conciliatory toward Iran. But we don't know what it means in practical terms. If I were Iran, you know, I think it might be good to sort of cool it for a little while, maybe not have another test, and not have any kind of a provocation in the Persian Gulf, because we just don't know what this administration is capable of. So, you know, let everybody just cool it for a while. We have enough tension in the world, and we don't need any more.
You said it best. I mean, just stay calm and cool. Let this time get pass by, and hopefully we get the better days, you know. And I really appreciate it. Just whenever you have some meeting or something that there is something going on in Atlantic Council, please feel free to let me know, and I share it with my viewer. You know, we have so many Iranian even in this DMV area, Virginia.
I know.
Yeah. And once again, I thank you for being with us. I know how busy you are. You even said 5 to 10 minutes. I said, okay. If there is anything you want to say to our viewer at the end of interview, please go ahead and say that.
Sure. Just please do not judge Americans by what you see coming out of the White House. There are many Americans who feel differently, and we will continue our efforts to have a good and healthy relationship between the United States and Iran.
Thank you so much. Hope to see you more often. Thank you.
Thank you. My pleasure. Okay. Bye-bye.
خب دوستان عزیز با خانم باربارا اسلاوین بودیم. ایشون سالهای سال هست که فعالیت میکنن و دیدید که چقدر قشنگ گفتن که لطفاً قضاوت نکنید صحبتهایی رو که الان به اصطلاح گاورمنت یا دولت آمریکا داره انجام میده و یه مقداری هم خون سرد باشید. بذارید این مدتی که الان آقای ترامپ اومده و میخواد به اونایی که بهش رأی دادن ثابت کنه که من اینجا میگن بیگ شات، بله من خیلی قدرت دارم و اینها. بذارید این هرچی میخواد داد و بیداد کنه، هرچی میخواد فحاشی کنه. شما فحاشی نکنید و به قول خانم میشل اوباما که گفت که هرچی اونا میرن پایین، یعنی ببخشید اینو میگم، هرچی اونا پست فطرت تر میشن، شما سعی کنید که شخصیت خودتونو بالا نگه دارید تا این زمان هم بگذرد. داریم دیگه، بگذرد این روزگار تلختر از زهر، بار دیگر روزگار چون شکر آید. ممنونم که با ما بودید. تلویزیون مردم رو به دیگران هم معرفی کنید. روز روزگار بر شما خوش.